Hey folks, welcome to the channel. In today's build, we're going to start a new project, a Damascus cleaver. Never made a cleaver before, so it's going to be something new to start with. And this one's going to have an integrated bolster, and it's going to be raindrop Damascus. So let's take a look. Please like and subscribe. It really helps me out. Let's go start this build.
Probably the most important part of starting any Damascus billet is getting it nice and clean. I always start with the surface grinder, clean off all my steel, then go clean them all off with acetone before I stack them. I'm doing my regular 31 layer billet. This one is 16 layers of 1/8 inch 1095 and 15 layers of 0.049 inch 15 and 20. I make all my Damascus billets 4 inches in length. Then I only have to weld the corners. I don't like welding the center, a line down the center, because it's just harder to get off. I also don't like welding a long handle onto the billet just because then I can't close the door on the forge. So I usually just leave a small little handle and then use bolt jaw tongs. This was my first time really using the new forge, and I'm using it for forge welding. I think it was running at about 1 PSI or maybe a little higher. Worked really well. My process for setting a new forge weld is to heat it up to about red and then apply some flux. And then I'm going to heat it up till it's really, really bright yellow. The flux should be almost steaming off of it. Then I'm going to press it lightly in the forge and I'm going to repeat that 2 more times. I always do it 3 times before I get aggressive. After the 3rd press, I stop using flux. It's forge welded at this point. Once the forge weld is set and I've reduced it down a bit, I like to take it to the grinder and just grind off the welds, just to make sure that I don't get those included into the steel at any point. Now I'm just going to draw this out, getting ready for the restack. The restack's going to be 4 layers, so I'm going from 31 to 124. So we need to make sure I have enough length to get to 4 pieces. Now it's time to slice it up on the bandsaw and grind off all the scale on the edges that are going to touch. I didn't show it here, but I started with an angle grinder before I moved to the 2x72. Here I just tack weld the layers together, put another handle on, into the kerosene, and then rinse and repeat. We're going to be doing 1 more 4-way restack after this to bring it to a total of 496 layers. The reason for such a high layer count, well, first of all, I want the raindrop to look really nice. Plus, there isn't going to be a really high bevel on this, so I can't just, you know, I'm not going to use a random pattern because there won't be a high bevel to kind of expose that. So I really need the raindrop to look nice for the blade. This equal measure tool is perfect for this kind of thing. You don't have to do any math when slicing up your billet. There's a link to where to get one of these in the description. This is the final restack, and this is where things get a little interesting. I wanted the heel of the knife to be right under the bolster so it had really good balance. The first thing I needed to do is isolate some of the steel for the bolster and for the tang. That can be tricky to do sometimes because the steel doesn't always move the way you want it. I managed to use this 1-inch piece of plate to my advantage. Now I'm drawing out the tang, and it ended up being a little long, so I wish I would have drawn it out the other way and got some width out of it. I moved to the anvil to do some more work on the tang. This part actually gave me the most problem of the build, was getting the tang just right. One of the problems I had here is making the tang too long. When you do an integrated bolster, that really becomes part of your handle, so you really need to include that as part of the length. Now that I've got the tang and the bolster set, I'm moving on to fullering out the blade so I can get the length, and I also need to make sure the heel goes underneath the bolster.
So I've got the basic shape of this cleaver done, kind of have a handle, integrated bolster. It's really thick, but it's time to put the raindrop pattern in. And to do that, I'm just going to use some drills and drill a bunch of holes that are maybe a 16th, between a 16th and an 8th, so 3/32nd, into this on both sides. And then we're going to flatten it out in the forge. I actually tried just doing while it was hot, because I've actually seen someone do this before, and I thought, man, that's going to just wreck a drill bit. So I used an old drill bit, and it lasted about, whatever, 8 holes, and then it wouldn't drill anymore, and I wrecked the drill bit. So that's not going to work. So I annealed it, and let's drill some holes.
Based on some discussion with another smith, I wanted to make sure I had different size holes so you see different size drill bits being used here to achieve a non-symmetrical pattern.
Okay, folks, there it is. Ready for the forge.
Now we have to forge this flat, and that will bring the layers at the bottom of the holes up to the surface, and it'll produce rings so you'll get raindrops. When I put the pattern up to my steel, I just wasn't happy with the handle, and this started a 2-hour adventure on trying to fix it, which didn't really turn out. I did take it to the forge and thin it out a little more just to make sure it was the right thickness. I tried to upset the handle by hitting it on the end, and that just didn't work. I ended up widening the handle just a bit right behind the bolster, and I think that's going to do it.
So here we are after the forging. I just cut the tip off this because I got a little more than I need. The handle's a little longer, so I'm gonna have to take this handle off a bit here, reshape it, but I think it'll look okay. Also, this bolster is gonna get squared up, so that actually will make the handle a bit longer here anyway. So it's actually gonna be, it's gonna kind of come down here, so it'll, or I might make it come up and swoop up here, whatever, I'll figure it out. But this top edge is going to come off, this is going to kind of, whatever, I'll figure out what I'm going to do here, and that's what it's going to be. All right, let's get to the grinder.
I remember why integrated bolsters are a pain in the ass. You can't just lie it flat on your rest and grind it, so I had to get something else. I have a certain method here. I always like to do the profile and then go back and take the scale off the blade. There's no point in taking all the scale off parts that aren't going to be in your profile anyway. Now I'm just hogging off some of the steel on the blade and then moving to the small wheel attachment to put that well in underneath the bolster.
So I've got the initial grind done, or part of the initial grind done on this cleaver. It still needs a lot of refinement. It's still super thick, but I want to square up the bolster. So what I'm going to do is just use a height gauge. You can see I put two lines on it here. I want to put lines so I can grind the bolster so it's the same thickness on either side before I go much further. So let's get that done. So I've got my lines marked out, so where I need to grind to. Once I've done that, I've got this block here that I'm going to place on here because I want this plunge to actually be on an angle like that. So I'm just going to bolt these on either side so that I'll have a guide of where I'm going to put the small wheel up to get that bevel, and I'll get it the same on both sides. So that's what we're going to do. Now that I've taken these down to the right dimensions, I got this locked in, I can just now put my markers on it. Now I see where they're marked off to. All right, small wheel attachment, let's grind those down.
Sorry folks, I didn't realize I didn't have the camera on until after I ground the bolster. So I'm thinning down the blade here.
I got a lot of meat off of the blade. It's a little thick, but that's fine for heat treat. What I need to do now is mill out the back side of the bolster. You can see it's not even here, so I'm just gonna mill this. The problem is seating this in the vise on the mill. Normally, this is what I use to lock knives in. This has been basically milled with these two bolts that totally recess. But you can see, not big enough. So I had to make this guy, which is the blade will sit in the middle, just barely, and that will let me lock this thing in, and so that I can flip it over and do the other side, and I'll just indicate one side so I know where it is. So that's what we got to do next. Here it is after milling the bolster. I decided I would just mill out the handle, which was good and bad. Because this wasn't supported very well, I got a little chatter, if you can see, right along here. It kind of dug in here a little bit, and same here. So, because that's going to show on a full tang knife, I have a little problem. So I think I'm actually going to just taper the tang and have this just a little thinner. So another challenge. I'll taper the tang after the heat treat. But right now it's pretty even. Feels nice. It'll be nice and sturdy. I don't love that there's 90 degree edges here. I'm thinking I should have used a ball end mill to do that section, but oh well, we'll see how it goes. Feels good in the hand. It's got a decent weight, and we'll take a little more weight off of it after heat treat. So let's do some normalizations.
What you're hearing is my son playing guitar upstairs that the camera picked up, but it only picked it up when it's in fast forward. Very strange, but cool.
Here it is after the heat treat and temper. It's a nice straw color. I'll try to zoom in so you guys can see the pattern on it. I think it looks pretty good. I'm not sure if the camera's picking that up, but I think the raindrop turned out really well. That's it for this video. We'll finish it off in the next one.
Hey folks, thanks for joining me on this build. In the next one, we'll do the final grinding. We will finish it off, put a handle on it, and it'll be done. Can't wait to see the pattern on this one. If you haven't, like and subscribe, please. Helps me out. We'll see you on the next build.